Hi friends, welcome to my channel, and this is the 12th video of VMware VCP 5.5 vSphere training. And in this video I'm going to show you how to create virtual machine clone and template. So let's have some idea about my demo environment. As previously, I have basically 5 machines. First one is my Win2K DC01, which is my Active Directory server on which I have installed Active Directory and DNS role. Here you can see my Win2K 12 DC01. I have installed Active Directory and DNS config DNS. And my second machine is my vCenter server, on which I have installed vCenter application. You can see here my vCenter server is connected with my two ESXs, which is ESX01 and ESX02. So I'm connected with both the server by using the vSphere client. And the last one is my standalone Starwind machine, you can say, which is providing learn to my ESX host. This is my physical machine on which I am recording this video. You can see here Starwind application is installed, and I have provided the 3 learns to my ESX host. And here you can see all the 3 learn is connected with the ISKC session, which is multipathing. We have 2 connection for each host to each learn, so we have total 6 connection for 3 disk from the each ESX host. And so let's go and create a first clone. So as previously our video, I have installed Win2K 8 R2 machine, which we have installed Windows Server 2008 R2 operating system. And before moving any further thing, I want to clone this machine, because this machine is, you can say, if I open the console and power on the machine, this machine is like done the installation, and I have done the basic configuration like renaming the machine and few other things like installing the VM tools on this machine. So I have done these things, so just check out once more time. So you can see I have installed the VM tool on this machine, so my mouse is working perfectly fine. And if you go here, you can see so I have renamed this machine, and this machine is not activated, Windows is not activated, so seems everything good. I have done the basic configuration, so I am good to go to clone this machine before doing any further changes on this machine. So if required, if something goes wrong, then we can back to this machine. So I'm going to shut down this machine. So you can see machine is now shut down. So I'm going to right click on this and just go and click on clone. So provide the clone name. I'm going to provide it to Win2K8R2 clone. And definitely I'm going to put this machine in my India data center. Click next, and we need to select the ESX host. You can see validation is succeeded on both the ESX host, so going to deploy this clone on ESX2. And here you can see it's asking for data store, so I'm going to put this on my LAN 0. You can see validation succeed. Click next. And here is the option power on this virtual machine after KS and don't customize. So I'm going to leave the default settings. And here you can see the detail by which it's going to create a clone machine. So just click on edit virtual machine and continue. So you can see the all the details. Same hardware profile is also copied in a clone machine. Like I'm using the 1 GB RAM, 4 core and other details, same has been copied to here also. So click OK. And now you can see here clone virtual machine is running. It's almost 30-40% is completed, and copying virtual machine file. So it's basically copying the VMDK file or a hard disk file, which is in my case, which is around 40 GB. So it's copying the virtual hard drive for the Win2K8 R2 clone machine. So we have a same copy of file, same copy of virtual machine for both. So just give it some time, then we go and do further settings. So this is the basically thing how to clone a machine. Once the machine is cloned, we go ahead and create a template and deploy a machine by using the template. If you go in here, you can see my LAN 0 is, like, for now it's have around 59 GB free data free space. Once the copy is done, we can see the free space is like around 20 GB is less. So just wait to complete this copying virtual machine files. So you can see the clone virtual machine is completed successfully. We have here clone as well as, and if you go here in data store, you can see little warning because we have only around 20 GB space left, which is like 20%. So now we have a clone machine, virtual machine, and now we can go ahead and do some stuff on Win2K8 R2, and then we create a template by using this machine. So I'm going to power on this machine once again, and I'm going to do little bit changes as per my requirement, as per my template requirement. So power on machine. So there was many reason to create a template. Like, we can deploy thousands of machine, hundreds of machine by using the same template as per our requirement. Like, we have some settings, we have done some software installation, like you can say SQL Server, Visual Studio, MS Office, these things, and you have done the few settings as per your requirement, and then you have created the template, and you can deploy the same virtual machines by many times by using the few clicks. So good to go. So click enter to Dell. So in this case, just assume I have got the request from my server owner to create a template and the server owner require few features need to be added here in my server template. So just say like the server owner requires desktop experience, and you can say telnet client, and you can say one more thing is Windows Server backup features. So good to go. I have selected the all three options. Click next, and now we can see. You can see I have added the four features here as per requirement of my template, and I'm going to click on install. So it will install the all four features in my template machine as per requirement of server owner. And if the owner requires any further things like settings or application, you can just go and install the application. Like you can mount the ISO file, you can access the network share for like installation file and anything, and just go and install the application and then create a template. So in my case, I got the request for these four features only, so I'm going with these four features. So after the installation of few things, like you can say desktop experience, we require reboot for machine. So definitely after the installation, it will ask to reboot the machine. So we go ahead. Here you can see restart pending. So I'm going to restart my server. After that, we are good to go to create a template. So you can see configuring Windows feature, 2% completed. Do not turn off your computer. So machine is rebooting now. So finally we are at the controller Dell screen. Hit controller Dell and go ahead and log in on virtual machine. And just verify all the features which we have added. All four features have been installed successfully. So it's resuming the result here, resuming configurations. So you can see all the four features has been installed successfully. So click close. And also if you want to verify, you can click on feature and you can say four feature has installed. So we are good to go to create a template now. So in Windows, we have a sysprep to prepare the machine before the creating a template. So basically sysprep registered the all machine specific data. So there was no data related to machine specifications, machine individual machine dependency. So I'm going to run the sysprep before creating the template. So just click on sysprep and select the generalize option, and after the sysprep I want to shut down this machine by automatically. So we have done the settings, click OK. So now it will run the sysprep and it will reshut the all machine specific data and shut down the machine. So just wait for few minutes to get this done. So sysprep is completed, and also you can see the machine is shut down now. So we have done, and now we have two options. If I go right click on machine and template, we have two options: clone to template or convert this machine to template. So the first thing is convert to template means if I click on this, you can see machine is like gone from here because the machine is converted in template, and if you want to see, just click on inventory, and here you can see VMs and template. If I click here, now you can see the template is here, but its little icon is has been changed, and by this you can identify this machine is converted in template. So if you right click on here, you can see the we have option clone and convert to virtual machine. Like we have some requirement and server owner came back to us and he is telling us to install few other features or role on this server. Or also you can say like we have some Windows update or anything which needs to be installed, then we can convert this machine from template to like you can say virtual machine and install the software, install the Windows update, everything, then convert this machine back as a template. So I'm going to create this machine, convert this machine from template to virtual machine once, just to show you. So click on finish, and you can see mark as a virtual machine is running, and here you can see machine is converted to template is converted to virtual machines. So I'm going to do it back, convert machine to template, and now machine is converted to template. And if I right click, other option like deploy virtual machine from this template, add permission, delete from disk, rename, and these things. So I'm going to rename this, like I'm going to put here template, that's all. And now I'm going to rename this machine or leave it, or you can rename it like Win2K8R2 because we don't have any machine with the name. So in this video we have created one clone of Win2K8R2, then we have created a template of that clone machine, and then we have renamed this. So this is all about creating the template and deploying creating the clone from virtual machine. In next video I'm going to deploy machine by using this template. So thank you for watching. Please subscribe me for more videos, and if you have any question, any query related to this, please mail me on my given mail IDs. Thank you once again. Bye bye.